Today we're going to show you how you can get that really smooth cream colour on the outside of Cypher's robes. And to do this, what you need to do is start out with a base coat of Xandri Dust, and then we're going to shade the robes using Agrax Earth Shade. After that, we'll add a layer of a Shabti Bone, and then a highlight a Screaming Skull, and after that, we'll add some weathering to it by using Agrax Earth Shade once more. But starting out with our base coat of Xandri Dust, I'm going to apply this with a medium base brush, and as always, you need to make use of your palette here to thin your paint down so it applies really smoothly. And once you've done so, all you've got to do is start painting this onto the robes. And with this colour, you will need to apply two thin coats. Next, shade all the creases of the fabric using Agrax Earth Shade. You want to paint them in here for some fairly neat lines. If you do make any mistakes, just neaten up with Xandri Dust once more before you continue. Once that shade's completely dry, we're now ready to start adding some of Shabti Bone. Now for this layer, what you want to do is paint most of the cloak. But when you get to these creases, go most of the way down, but not all the way. For example, on this one, I'm just going to stop around about there. Then once this first coat's dry, I'll apply a second one, which goes up to about here, so the colour will get stronger towards the top of these creases. And this way, you get a nice transition as the fabric goes into the deeper recesses there, like that. Now we're ready to highlight the robes using Screaming Skull, and what you want to do here is follow along all the creases and tears, picking out all these sharpest points with some fine lines like this. And there we go, that's the cream of the cloak complete. Now if you want to add an extra effect to it, give the impression that it's been dragging through the dirt, what you can do is get some Agrax Earth Shade and apply with a small dry brush, and what you do is just start stippling this on like this to get a really random, grimy pattern along the base of the cloak. And there we go, Cypher's cloak is complete. And also you can see that weathering effect looks really good and it's really easy to do as well. So I really hope you guys have enjoyed that one, and we'll see you all again soon.